Dear students, in this session we will discuss about the numerical aperture of an optical fiber, and we will find the numerical aperture for an optical fiber cable. See, this is experimental setup. You can see here that there will be a power supply for the textbook, and this is the textbook that is Scientech 2501A. And here, first of all, we will see the input section, that is function generator section. First of all, we have to give an input to the transmitter side. That means we have to set the input at 5 volt peak to peak a sine wave. For that, we are taking the input from this point, that is the from the function generator, and the input cable. You can see here that this input cable, and where we will connect the probe of the CRO. You can see here, and the ground is connected to the ground section of the Scientech, and first we will set the input to 5 volt peak to peak, that is you can see in the CRO. Okay, so this is the input going to this emitter circuit section. You can see here that, and so that we will short circuit the A and B terminals of this emitter circuit terminals, and we will be taking the output from the output section. You can see here, you can see the light output. See, you can see a light coming from here. So we will connect this optical fiber cable having length 1 meter here. So you can see here, this is the optical fiber cable, and here for finding numerical aperture we are utilizing this thing, that is here there is a scale that is going up to 7 centimeter, that is 70 millimeter, and here also there is another thing. You can see this is used for numerical aperture measurement. Here different circles are there. The inner circle has a diameter of 10 millimeter, and the next to that the circle have 15 millimeter. Next the circle has 20 millimeter diameter, and next it is of 25 millimeter. So what we are doing is the connections are made here. You can see that light is coming through this fiber cable. See here, light is coming through this. Okay, so to find the numerical aperture we are pointing this light to this circles. So let us see. See, here is the experimental setup. You can see here we are pointing that light coming through the optical fiber cable to this card, where there are different circles, and here we are actually pointing that circle exactly to the central circle, so that its diameter is 10 millimeter. That is for taking the easiness for taking the value of the diameter. Now you can see here, it is exactly pointing to that center circle whose diameter is 10 millimeter, and you have to go to the horizontal reading for that central diameter. You can see the horizontal reading there is, you can see it is clearly, that is around 1.3 millimeter. So you can write that reading in the paper. See, first for diameter is 10 millimeter and the horizontal length is 1.3 millimeter, that means 13 millimeter. Sorry, 1.3 centimeter, that is 13 millimeter. So you can find out the numerical aperture. Calculation we can done in the next section. And next we will point that light in the nearest higher circle, that is having diameter 15 millimeter. For that we have to move this card in the horizontal direction, move away from that light. Okay. So now you can see it is moving away, so that you can see light is pointed to the next higher circle. You can see the light is filled to the next higher circle, and you can see the corresponding corresponding length. You have to calculate the corresponding length. Now you can take the reading. Now it is filled to the second circle, and next you can take the reading. See, here the horizontal distance is 2.3 6 centimeter, that is equal to 26 millimeter, and corresponding circle diameter is 15 millimeter. That is the diameter of the circle in that card is 15 millimeter and the corresponding length is 26 millimeter. And next case, again we will move the card so that the light will point to the third circle. You can see now we are moving away that card from the light source so that the light will fill the third circle. Little more. Okay, now you can see it is almost filled the third circle. So you can take the reading in the horizontal scale. So the reading is 3.7, that is equal to 37 millimeter, and next circle diameter is 20 millimeter. Next, in the case, fourth case, you are taking the diameter such that the light is filled in the fourth circle, and actually I am doing, in order to see the light wave correctly, I am reducing the brightness of the camera. So you can see that now when you are moving away, the light is filled to the fourth circle, which is having diameter 25 millimeter. Now it is almost filled to the fourth circle. So it is better to do this experiment in a dark room, then you will get the correct measurements. Now the light is almost filled to that final circle of diameter 25 millimeter, and the corresponding length is 4.6. okay, so 4.6 meter means 46 millimeter. That is the fifth reading. So this is the readings that you have obtained through this. So you have to calculate the numerical aperture by using this reading. So you will get a different values. Then you will get a numerical aperture. Let us see the calculation. For that, here we have some reference values that we have obtained in the laboratory records. You can see here that here for a diameter 10 millimeter, the length is 5, and for the diameter 15, the length is 7. Like that, different readings are obtained, and by using the numerical aperture equation, calculate the numerical aperture, and also they calculated the theoretical value of numerical aperture. And it is obtained as that this practical value is 0.707, and from the data sheet the numerical aperture is given as 0.5, that is almost equal. So this is the way you have to do this experiment. So it is better to do this experiment in a dark room, then only you will get the correct filling of that light by the circles. Actually, numerical aperture represents the light gathering ability of the fiber. So this is given as here in this experiment, it is obtained from the readings as it is 0.707. It is approximately equal to the 0.5, which is the theoretical value of numerical aperture of this cable. Okay, that's all about this topic. Thank you.